Let's talk about blend modes in Procreate. I'm going to draw with some blue paint on my layer number one. I'm going to add a new layer above that, change my color, let's go with pink, and add some more paint on top. So the easiest way to talk about blend modes, I find, is to just start by experimenting. You're always going to use two separate layers when you use a blend mode, and you'll always change the higher layer. So in this case, my layer two is above layer number one. The default blend mode is normal, which you can see by the letter N right here. Tap on that N to open up your blend modes list. If you go up in this list, these are your darkening blend modes. Let's go up to multiply. You'll notice that now the pink blob is no longer pink. Let's scroll back down the list to normal. Now if we scroll down, the ones right below normal are your lightning blend modes. So you'll see here that we have a lightning effect going on. The pink is now light pink instead of that dark pink. Going even further, you get some more interesting combinations. So difference is going to give us an orange. Subtract gives you green. And some of these don't really look like they've changed anything. So I recommend when you're working with blend modes that you scroll through these lists to find what looks good to you. That's often the easiest way if you're getting started, because there is a whole lot of technical definition, which I'm going to get a little bit into, but this would be a very long video to get into all of it. So basically, in digital art, every color is made up of a mathematical value. So each pixel has a numerical value assigned to it based on the color. I mean, you can even see here inside your value tab of the colors, you can see numbers. And as you change your numbers, your color changes. And of course, colors are made up of multiple attributes. So if you're looking at RGB, that's how much red, green, and blue are in your color. Or if you're looking at hue, saturation, brightness, that's how much saturation, hue, and brightness is in each color. And each one has a different numerical value assigned to it. So if you scroll through your colors, you can see all of those numbers are changing. So the way that blend modes work is through math. The technical definition of a multiply blend mode, for example, is multiply blend mode takes the RGB channel values of each pixel in the top layer and multiplies them with the values for the corresponding pixels from the layer below it. Because of the way that math works, the multiply blend mode is always going to produce a color that's darker. Let's go back to normal. Now, some of the modes are a little bit easier to understand. So for example, if we scroll down to lighter color, you can see that the pink disappears. There's no more pink because the blue is lighter than the pink. If I scroll up to darker color, it's going to show pink instead because it's looking at the pixels that are on top of each other, pink and blue, and figuring out which one is darker. In this case, pink is darker. Now, some interesting things can happen when your shapes are overlapping. So scrolling down through here, this layer is also interacting with the background color layer. So for each and every one of these blend modes, there's a mathematical formula of how the colors are relating to one another. And you can read about the descriptions on the Adobe website. Also, if you go to the Wikipedia page for blend modes, you can read all about those definitions and see the mathematical formulas, and it's very interesting. I highly recommend it. But in most cases, you can just scroll through the blend modes and figure out which one looks good for the effect that you're going for. Also, if you're a student of our Procreate Lettering Projects course, check out the blend modes cheat sheet that we've provided for you, which shows you the most common blend modes that we use for calligraphy and lettering and how they work. Now, one last note, layer order matters. So if I have my pink layer set to multiply and then I move that underneath the blue layer, well, now I don't get that same effect because the blue layer is covering the pink layer and the blue layer blend mode is set to normal. And actually, if you scroll down to multiply here on the blue layer, then you'll get a similar effect. So in general, always change the blend mode of your top layer to see how that interacts with the layer below it. Hey, if you liked this video, subscribe to our channel for more and check out our other tutorials on Procreate. You also might like our free iPad calligraphy practice brush. It's a color changing brush that helps you learn how to control your pressure as you're writing calligraphy. You can get the free brush plus a bunch of practice worksheets available on our website at loveleyloops.com/freebrush. Check the description to download yours. Thanks again for watching and happy digital lettering.